What's up, y'all? It's the Majin 9. It's time for another one. So yeah, welcome to another day of the Hyperspace Run. I hope you're having a great day out there. And before we get into our featured topic, which is Mace Windu, I figured I should talk about this because when I looked on Twitter today, you just couldn't really turn any down any thread and not see this story pop up. And we actually talked about this probably a few weeks ago, almost a month ago now. And as it stands, we have another LGBTQ comic book hero in the form of Jonathan Kent, a character that came out 6 years ago, almost 7 years ago, and they decided now they want to have him be bisexual. So here's the thing I want to say about this, right? And, you know, coming out, I guess that's the headline. But to me, the real headline is really, why is there so much cowardice when it comes to these creators out there? You know, just make a character that's, you know, LGBT, and don't take a character that never was like that, like AKA Tim Drake and Iceman and all the stuff that's going like that, like characters that show no. And we talk about, you know, several decades, especially when we talk about Iceman, where there was no indication that he was part of the LGBTQ team. You know what I'm saying? There was no indication of it. But you want to go ahead, because we know what this really is, right? We know what this is. You want to use the name, the brand, and then you tack that agenda to it to give it more weight. Rather than, if you come down here and you look at this, and by the way, this is from Variety, this article I have here. So if you see right here, you have North Star, one of the very first openly gay comic book characters that came out in 1992. Rather than building on that character and creating characters, you know, like North Star, you go ahead and you make, you know, Harley Quinn, Alan Scott, which I'm pretty sure if you're talking about the original, the first Green Lantern, it probably was not in the LGBT. America Chavez, cool. She's a brand new character. And to be fair, Jonathan Kent, like I said, came out in 2015, so that's a relatively new character. But again, it is a lot of cowardice. I mean, because look, let's be 100%. The days of, like, when, you know, people were just being openly, you know, bigoted towards people of the LGBT, it's fading away rapidly. As a matter of fact, I don't think I've known anybody who's done that. I mean, we got laws and stuff that protects people at this point, right? So that, at least as far, again, that's me being a little, using my own anecdotal evidence, but, you know, from what I've seen, I've never seen that, ever. I saw more stuff that would be contrary to that in movies and stuff. And that's coming from the beloved Hollywood, who's trying to, and by the way, to me, this seems like an actual over conversations because they know they were the ones that perpetuated most of this stuff anyway. But in real life, you never see, I never seen that stuff, right? But again, to me, it's a form of cowardice that you can't go ahead and create your own characters. And it's laziness on top of that, cowardice and laziness. Because if you were strong in your convictions, make a new character that's gay, bisexual, you know, different pronouns, whatever you want to do. Make a new character that does that. But we understand now, I mean, it's not even now, it's been made clear throughout the past, since probably like 2016, really 2012 when they started doing the all different Marvel and stuff like that. We've seen this is the thing. Everything has to be changed, and you take the, what they like to call the mantle, which a lot of these things shouldn't even be a mantle when you're talking about paper and drawings. Because again, one of my biggest things is Bruce Wayne could be Batman from now until, you know, the sun stops shining, because comic books are pen and paper. You know, he can stay his 30s forever. You know what I'm saying? Obviously you can't do that with live action, which that goes the problem with doing live action stuff. But again, there's no need for a mantle where you could just have new characters. You know what I'm saying? So I can almost understand it for live action, because your actors and actresses aren't going to stay young forever. But even then, I still say do the James Bond method, right? Do the James Bond method and just change the actor and just say that's the same person. I mean, we've seen it done before. Rhodey's one of the things. James Bond is a whole another thing. I mean, it that's just how it works, right? But with that being said, all I want to say is it's a meme. We all notice at this point. Just if you guys out there who are still hanging on to mainstream comics, just know at some point your character will be changed. That's just how the game is being played now. Your character that you grew up loving, that you had a connection to, whether it be white, black, female, male, lesbian, bisexual, whatever that character was, it will be changed. Let me correct myself. The lesbian and bisexual and all that stuff like that, LGBT stuff, that's never going to change. That's actually going to become more of the norm, which it was. At this point, it's normal at this point anyway. I mean, I don't know where people get this constant, we have to constantly keep making this seem like it's okay. It's been okay. Nobody's ever said it's not okay. But again, that's where we're at. But anyway, let's get into our main topic. Boom, this is from Pirates and Princesses. Big shouts to Geeky and Neon over there, because this is their site over here. Mace Windu comic book art receives online backlash after Disney yanked the Star Wars license. So, I saw this floating around. It's been floating around for a bit. Now, this is supposed to be Mace Windu. What the actual F, Disney? What the actual F? So, you're going to put this out, right? And this is the company that wants to reimagine tomorrow. But you do something so regressive as this. Is anybody driving that machine over there? Or are we all asleep at the wheel? Because it just seems like there's no real leadership going on in this company, in Lucasfilm, right? And I call this a Disney problem, because I don't recall any of this being a situation when it was under one person. Well, let's check out this article. Let's see what they got to say. It says the issue of Star Wars comic book is causing a bit of a stir online as people think Samuel Jackson's iconic Jedi Master Mace Windu looks like a racist caricature and a bit, well, simian. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. The image from the IDW Publishing's Star Wars Adventures number 9, published in 2020, this is from last year, which, wow, man, it's crazy it took this long for people to notice it. It should be noted that Windu does not look quite as off in the other panels of the book, and is likely that the artist's style is not a deliberate trolling. And Windu has been drawn many times in other Star Wars comics, and they somehow managed to not make him look awful. Exactly. However, that didn't stop Twitter users to question why the IDW's editors didn't catch this image before going into press, especially when Disney's increase on focus on diversity and inclusion. Absolutely. Absolutely. While the kind of outrage might be normal to push Disney to react, it's unnecessary. IDW's publishing is ceasing the publication of both and all images of Marvel Comics and Star Wars lines. Oh, well, so that there you go. That's probably why they didn't let that ride. The word is that Disney pulled the license for unknown reasons and not likely related to the particular issue. Anyway, they say this is a bad look in current year. Absolutely. so, yeah, this is the image, and I'm like, oof. What were you guys thinking? And I actually, you know, me, I saw this when I saw it on Twitter. I'm like, what the actual F is, you know, because it's the truth. Like, what were you guys thinking, man? I don't get it. Like, how could you do something that stupid and let that ride? But again, and this is the same company that has this right here, Reimagining Tomorrow, and which is crazy. Chat replay is disabled, so this is for the chat replay. But yeah, so this has Reimagine Tomorrow from Reimagine Tomorrow. This is from Disney, I would assume so. Yeah. And I mean, if you look at the ratio, 119 upvotes to 1,400 downvotes, with only, you know, just 9,500 views, and this is a Disney property. And you know, just the fact that they always try again. It's the same thing I was saying about the first topic. It's like Hollywood is notorious for doing questionable things, right? And it's almost like they're overcompensating, you know, when it comes to the diversity and inclusion, all the way to things like the, you know, the Me Too thing, all that stuff like that, because this is stuff that Hollywood does themselves, you know? And it's just like they're overcompensating for something. And it doesn't help when you're letting stuff like this slide. That doesn't help you. It doesn't help your case in all, at all. It does not help it at all. But anyway, that's our couple topics for today. Let me know how you feel about this. Do you think that it's a cowardice technique that these comic book writers are doing now? They constantly got to just, you know, slap LGBT on characters that didn't even start like that, didn't have no indication of it. And while I do say that, you know, being that Jonathan is a relative new character, still, almost 7 years later, you're talking about changing him now, and like, okay, you could have did that from the jump, but whatever. And of course, what do you feel about the Mace Windu terrible drawing? Let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, and subscribe, and of course, hit that notification button so you get my videos on the drop them. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. And ride safe out there. Peace.